Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at some Google search tricks. So let's start off with the simplest one that you may already know. You can search a specific website by typing site colon and then the name of the website, no space after the colon. So if I wanted to search MacMost.com, I would do that and then I would type in the search term. So I can do keynotes, look for keynote tutorials. And you can see all the results here are at MacMost.com, not other websites. So it's a quick and easy way to search a website, especially if the website doesn't have a very good search feature. For instance, here I've searched discussions.apple.com for iPod screen cracked, and so you can get right to posts that have that in the title or in the body of the page. So here's something that even people that use site colon don't even know. You can do a restrict the search to a dot, like .gov here, just by typing it like that. And then you can say, look for something and restrict it to only .gov websites or .org or .edu. Here's another one you may already know. You can use quotes to search for something exactly. So for instance, search for Mac Mini, those two words appearing exactly together, you put quotes around it. And you can still put other search terms there, but it will always make sure that it's searching for Mac and Mini together, not just as two separate words. You can also use a modifier before a search word, like for instance minus. So if I search, say, Mac right here, you could see I come up with lots of hits for cosmetics. So I could eliminate that by putting minus cosmetics, and I won't get any search results with that word in it again. You can also limit the date range for search terms. So for instance, I can do pages tutorials 2010 dot dot, and it's have two periods there, 2013, and it will search for that range. You can use that with years, but you can also use that with numbers like monetary values for searching for prices. Now, like the site colon modifier, you can actually use something called file type to search for a specific file type. So you can do, say, Mac keyboard shortcuts, and you could do file type, just one word there, colon, and then a common name of file type, like PDF. And now I search, and you can see I get only PDF results for Mac keyboard shortcuts. You could also use in title, colon, to search for a specific word or words in the title. So, for instance, I can do pages tutorial, and my results will always have pages tutorial in the title of the page. Here's a cool one that few people know about. You can use an asterisk to have a placeholder word. So for instance, you can do this. You can do a quote, then I want, and then asterisk for Christmas. And the results will be terms that say I want and then something for Christmas. So I can do that with all sorts of different searches and come up with some interesting results. So Google's got some interesting things that you could search for. For instance, you can use define and colon and get a definition, a dictionary definition from Google. You can also do cool things like you can do math and get not only the results, but you can get a little calculator that then you can use to continue getting calculations. You can also do some really cool stuff like, for instance, conversions. So you can say 56 inches in meters and get the result there and then modify that result from there. And that works also for currency. So you can say that and you can get a quick currency conversion, even with a little chart of the exchange rates. You can get flight status right in Google without having to go to a website. All you need to do is know the number for the flight. So type in just a random flight I looked up and you can see I get the current flight status for it. And this also works. You can also type in a package tracking number, either a FedEx package tracking number or a UPS one. So if you get an email and it's got a tracking number in it, they're usually pretty long, you can copy and paste it in here and then it will give you tracking information right there without having to go to a specific website. Google also lets you look up sports scores. So you can basically type the name of a sports team. And right there at the top it gives you previous results and the next game. And you can jump to various websites. For instance, I think this will take it just to the NBA website for those recaps. You can also search for movie times really easily. Just type the name of the movie and then movie times. And right here at the top of Google you'll get local movie theater times. So in two last things, you can type a name of a location and then weather, and you get a little weather report here at the top of Google. And in addition to that you can type in sunrise and get a quick sunrise time and sunset as well. So keep in mind you can also combine a lot of these. For instance, you can put a search term in quotes and also use the minus symbol for subtracting a search term, and then use site colon to restrict the results to a specific website. So you can combine lots of these together to get even more accurate search results. So I hope you found this useful. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.